How are you all? Doing good? So today you are having revision test 2 chapters. Which chapter? 4 and 5, that is MS Word. And I am going to upload the test at exactly 4 p.m. right? So you have to do the test very neatly and send the test on time. Make proper PDF. Rotate the pages and scan properly. Okay, so we will be revising the test today, that is chapter 4 and 5, MS Word. So are you all prepared for the test thoroughly? So let's revise now. So we will be revising various options in MS Word and the commands also. So I'm going to revise the topic with the help of practical topic that is given on page number 62 in your book. A poster is given. So we will be revising all the commands and all the options related to that. So should we start? Right? Okay. So first thing, I have to add page borders to my document. For adding the page borders, you can see the command is under the design tab. So you have to go on the design tab. Under the design tab, bache, the option is in the page background group, that is page borders. Clear? Once again, look at the command properly. Look at the screen. Design tab, page background. Under the page background, the option is page borders. So when you will click on the page borders option, you want to apply the page border to the document. So under the page border tab, you have to choose the option box. And in the box, from the art section, now choose the desired border that you want to apply. Now, according to the question, this is the selected border, right? So when I will choose this border, then the next thing is to set the width of the border from here. So I'm taking it as 12 points, apply to the whole document. So when you will click on the OK border, the page borders will be applied. This thing is clear to all, how I have applied the page borders. So once again, design tab, page background group, page border option. From the page border, you can choose the desired border and then you have to apply it to the whole document. You can set the width for the border as I have chosen 12 points here. So you can choose accordingly. The next thing is I have to insert a word art now. What is word art? Who will tell? What is word art? Yes. Very good. So word art feature of MS Word lets you add stylish text to the document. Word art feature lets you add stylish text of the document. And how we are going to insert the word art? What is the command for so? What is the command for inserting the word art? What is the command? How we can apply it? Yes, very good. Insert tab. Very good. So command for doing or inserting the word art. Insert tabs. Now you can look at the screen carefully. Insert tab. Under the insert tab, the group is text. Insert tab, text group, word art option. Now from the word art style gallery, choose the desired word art style. So this is the gallery of the word art now. I have to choose the desired word art style from here. So let it be, I'm choosing this. Now keep it in the center. You can increase the size like this. So I have increased the size now. Clear? Now, select the text in the text box, then type the text or edit the text that you want to change. So according to the question, it's save the earth. Clear? So let it be, I'm choosing. I'm making it as 52. So this is to set it now. Now you can see, bache, once you have inserted the word art from the command, insert tab, text group, word art option. Once again, repeat the command after me. Word art option. Very good. Once you have inserted a word art, any object you are inserting in the document, there will be format tab for formatting the particular object. So when I have inserted this word art, you can see under the drawing tools, the format tab is appearing. Click on the format tab for making the formatting. So this is the word art styles. So once again, you can change it from here. So whatever the style you want to change, I'm keeping it the same. Then next is to choose the outline for the word art, right? From here, you can choose the word art outline. So I'm choosing the outline. You can then choose the text fill also. So I'm taking this color. Then you can apply the shadow also, like this, outer shadow, inner shadow. So whatever the shadow effects you want to give. Then again, word art styles, reflections are there. So you can give the reflections. So let it be, we will be choosing this now. Next. Glow, if you want to give, this is not compulsory, or depends upon the formatting. Then transformation, so these things you can apply, right? The next thing is I have to insert a picture now. So what is the command for picture? What is the command? Yes, Harshika?
Insert tab pictures option.
What is the group? No. Very good. It's insert tab, illustrations group, picture option. Insert tab, illustrations group, picture option. So when you will follow this command, click on it, choose the desired picture that you want to insert. So let it be, I'm inserting this picture, select the desired picture and then click on insert. So this way the picture has been inserted. You can resize it by dragging the corner handles. So these are the corner handles, like this, you can increase or decrease the size. Now, how this picture will be moving? It will not be moving now. So what we can do is select the picture, go to the wrap text option, click on in front of text. So picture will be moved easily now. Clear? Now, when you have inserted the picture, once again, you can format it. So what are the various options under the format tab for formatting and picture, for formatting and inserted picture? So you have inserted a picture, after that you want to format it. So name various options. Yes, Raymond. Raymond?
Yes, ma'am.
Various formatting options for the picture?
Ma'am, different frame picture styles, arrangement of the pictures, and outline and borders of the pictures with color and simple lines.
Just the operations that you are seeing, these are not the exact options. You have to write the exact options for formatting the picture. Very good, very good. So let's look at the options now. Carefully look at the screen. Just look at the mouse pointer. So when you are inserting a picture, various formattings can be done. The options for the formatting are, number one, you can see, look at the mouse pointer only, artistic effects, and repeat after me. Number one, artistic effects, picture styles, picture border, wrap text, rotate, crop. Once again, artistic effects, picture styles, picture border, picture effects, wrap text, rotate, crop. All these are the options that will help in the formatting of a picture. Clear? So these are 6-7 options that is in our syllabus. So by using these options, we can format our picture. So I have inserted a picture here, right? So you can give the picture effects. Let it be, I'm giving the shadow like this. And then you can also give glow to your picture. Okay. So this way we have added the formatting, that is picture effects formatting to the picture. Next thing is, once again, I'm inserting a word art. So already we have learned the command insert tab, then text group word art option. Now I'm choosing the different word art. Let it be this style. So the text here will be now, every day is Earth Day. So you can increase the size. Now look at the different formattings for the same. So insert word art, go to the format tab. Under the format tab, these are the word art effects. So let it be one. Firstly, we are filling the color for the same. So let's choose blue color and then outline. Then is the transform. Right? So this way you can increase. Then give another formattings. Again, you can give bitter glow to it. Clear? Is it clear? Formatting for the word art, right? Next thing is to insert a shape. Command for inserting the shape? Illustrations group, shapes option. Insert tab. Illustrations group, shapes option. Side by side, learn the options and commands as well. Insert a illustrations group, shapes option. So I'm inserting a rectangle now. Now, can you name various shape options? Lines, rectangles, basic shapes.
Lines, call out basic shapes, flowchart, block arrows, stars, and banners.
Very good. Lines, basic shapes, call outs. Stars and banners, flow charts, right? Block arrows. So I have inserted a rectangle here now. So once again, when you have inserted a shape, various formatting or various options for the formatting of the shape now. Shape styles, shape fill, shape outline, shape effects. Once again, shape styles, shape fill, shape outline, shape effects. Clear? So these are the formatting options for the shapes. So now when you have inserted a shape, I just want to take an outline like this. Clear? So that the rectangle can be just a whiter one. Now you can see a very thin line for the border is appearing. So how we can set it? From the shape outline option, choose the weight of the line. So this way, the weight of the line can be increased. You have to choose the desired point for the borders, right? Then shape fill, I don't require any color inside it. Shape effects, if you want to give any shadow effects, so like this. Now, the next thing is how to add the text inside a shape. For adding the text inside the shape, you have to right click on it. After right clicking on the shape, a shortcut menu will appear. From the shortcut menu, choose the option add text. Clear? Choose the option, add text. So add text, clear it? So when I have chosen the add text option, the cursor is appearing now. Just we have to simply add the text here. So let it be, simple actions can make a big difference. Then plant more trees, save water, save electricity, conserve wildlife, reduce pollution, say no to plastic bags. Clear? Now we have to apply the formatting to a text. How we can do that? For giving the formatting, you can see according to the question. So this is in the red color. You can increase the size. Then the next feature or the next formatting I'm applying here is line spacing. So what is the command for line spacing? Home tab, paragraph group, line spacing option. Home tab, paragraph group, line spacing option. Name various line spacing options. 1.0, 1.15, 1.5, 2.0, 3.5. Clear? Once again, 1.0, 1.5, 2.0, 0.5, 3.0. So these are the line spacing options. Clear? So next thing is I have to set the line spacing for these now. Let it be, I'm taking 1.0, make it as bold, increase their size, and choose the height for the shape. Clear? So this thing is clear. Next formatting for the text given is highlighting. So let it be yellow highlighting as per the question. Next is, again a text is given. That is, for inserting the text, either you can choose the word art, but here I'm taking a simple text box now. So draw the text box. So just making a space for it now. Move a little upward. So that the proper utilization of space can be there. Clear? Now I have to add a text once again. So I'm drawing a text box here. Let us join hands to save this amazing planet. Make it in the center. So for that, the command for the alignment, home tab, paragraph group, choose desired line spacing option. Choose desired line spacing option from the home tab, paragraph group. Name various alignment options. Left align, center align, right align, justify. Four types of alignments are text, right, center, justify. So make it in the center. Make it bold. Increase the size. You can make this line a more broader. Clear? Now, I don't want to give outline for this text box. So what we will do is, again, go to the format tab. Shape outline should be no outline. Clear? So you can see now no outline is there, right? Because I have omitted the outline from the text box. Next thing, formatting of this. So this is in purple color. And then you can give a glow little. After that, shadow. This way, I have applied shadow to this effect. So now the complete document, bachche, you can see. Clear? How to make a particular poster or how to make a document in MS Word. So what all features we have used in creating this document? Number one, page borders. Then word art. Word art options we have used to make it more attractive. Then inserting picture. And to the picture, I have applied the glow effects. Then once again, word art. Then shape has been inserted. Text is being added to a particular shape. Formatting is done on the text. And here it was highlighting also. Then again, a simple text. For the text box, no outline has to be given with the help of no outline option. Then different formatting for the colors, for the font, and then the shadow effects. Clear? All the features, all the options, how to set alignment, what is the command for the alignment, types of alignment, line spacing options. So we have covered. So is it clear? Any doubt to anyone? Ikansh, you are asking, name various line spacing options. Then what we will have to write? No, you will not write double spacing or single spacing. Just simply add the options for the line spacing. And the options we have just discussed, 1.0, 1.15, 1.5, 2.0, 2.5, 3.0. So, bachche, now you can look at the complete output. So, you have to make this poster yourself now. Okay?